The iPhone voice assistant has never been great, and with all the delays to Apple Intelligence, who knows how long it will take to improve. Plus, now every AI app has its own voice assistant, and those actually being good, Apple seems even farther behind. Well, the AI app Perplexity has proven it can do way better than you-know-who. In the latest update, Perplexity can now control things on your iPhone, like adding reminders, calendar events, playing songs from Apple Music, playing Apple Podcasts, and a ton more. It's still limited compared to the built-in assistant because it doesn't have access to your smart home and other things, but it is very good at understanding what you want and getting it to you. So here's a side-by-side showing you everything Perplexity AI voice assistant can do right on your iPhone completely for free versus how the built-in assistant does it. Also, stay till the end because I built an advanced shortcut now for my action button for Perplexity and some other things. You can try this right now by downloading the Perplexity app, and you don't need to be subscribed to Perplexity Pro. You can do this for free. Turn on voice mode by tapping this icon here, and you can even ask it things like, what's everything you can do with my iPhone?
Such as sending emails, booking rides with Uber, playing music or videos, getting directions, and creating calendar events and reminders.
I do wish I could speed up that voice in the Perplexity app, but let's start with Apple Music. So unlike ChatGPT, which can't play music from Apple Music,
I can't play music for you.
Perplexity's new voice assistant is directly integrated with your library. Play Fantasy from Earth, Wind, and Fire.
I'm playing Fantasy by Earth, Wind, and Fire.
And then you have the option to open it in the Apple Music app, and there it is playing. So that's pretty cool, but I'll give the built-in voice assistant benefit of the doubt. Let's ask it. Play Shining Star by Earth, Wind, and Fire. So it can do that too. Now, if you ever ask your HomePod, you know it can be a little hit or miss, but let's try something a little more vague. Play that song that Jack Black sings to his dog in the Minecraft movie with Apple Music.
I'm playing Ode to Dennis by Jack Black from the Minecraft movie soundtrack. Enjoy the music.
It got it on the first try, and there's even a button to open it in Apple Music, and there it is. Now, I think I know what'll happen with the built-in assistant, but let's try it. Play that song that Jack Black sings to his dog in the Minecraft movie with Apple Music. Right. So just that kind of contextual awareness and being able to know what that song is and play it with Apple Music built in, pretty wild. Play that song that has both Ariana Grande and The Weeknd in it. You can also see when you make requests all the sources that it's accessing to find that information. Play that song with Ariana Grande and The Weeknd in it. Well, the built-in assistant got it too, just a different song. One of the other things Perplexity can do is actually play your podcast. Play the latest episode of the podcast Primary Technology. Now, Perplexity unfortunately can't actually start it playing for some reason. You actually have to tap the play button, and that is one place the voice assistant can do it right. Now, you can also search for restaurants, use Apple Maps, and even book a ride, so let's try that. Show me the best Vietnamese restaurants in Lakeland. Can you make a reservation at Saigon Bistro? So it looks like it'll get me directions to the restaurant, but the built-in assistant won't do a reservation. What are the best steakhouses in Lakeland? Can you make a reservation at Texas Cattle Company? So you do need to search here in OpenTable and then actually go to the restaurant to make the reservation, but it's nice it can open it for you. And again, you can get directions, but no reservations. I can go to the business and then maybe try to find it here or tap the reserve button in Maps, but the assistant can't actually do that. And Perplexity can also hail rides for you to a certain place. Can you get a ride to Texas Cattle Company in Lakeland? Then you are going to have to open the Uber app if you want to do a ride share. It gets you pretty far in the app to actually calling for the Uber, so that's nice. Can you hail a ride to Texas Cattle Company in Lakeland? All I can do is get directions. Now, I know in Maps, when you're getting directions to a business or location, you can hail a ride using Lyft or Uber when you go over to this tab in Maps, but this is not something the iPhone voice assistant can do on its own. And if you open it, it still has to open the Uber app just like Perplexity. Perplexity can also compose emails for you. Write an email to Nate about having lunch next week, maybe about Tuesday at 12 p.m. to discuss the new project about design. It does a pretty nice job of composing that email, and it's ready to go. Write an email to Nate Baranowski about having lunch next week, let's say Tuesday at 12 p.m. at Texas Cattle Company, and put the subject of the email as design project. Yeah, the built-in assistant didn't do as well of a job composing that. Also, Perplexity can create calendar events and reminders for you, put it in the Stock Reminders and Calendars app, but whatever events you add will only go to the default calendar you have set in Settings, and reminders can seem to actually add an alert, which is unfortunate. But it can add details to a calendar event, which let's try that by stringing a bunch of commands together. So I put together a string of commands, searching for the best coffee places in Lakeland, Florida, wanting to arrange a calendar event and inviting my friend Nate, talking about what I wanted to include, sending an email to him, and then getting an Uber to that coffee place. Now, Perplexity did it all, with no problem. You can see Perplexity added the event with a nice title. Siri somehow just couldn't do that and put a bunch of text in there. Also didn't include the location in the event. When I did it with the voice assistant on iPhone, it actually failed the first time. I had to start a new session. It put a lot of text in the subject of the email, which I guess is just how it understands it, and it just didn't understand me as well. Then to get an Uber, it will give me directions, and in the Maps app, I know I can tap the rideshare button and book it, but it is several more steps, and Perplexity just did it faster. Because Perplexity is a legit large language model, it's just able to parse your requests better and do things like writing that email, hailing a ride to a certain restaurant, and maybe even getting better suggestions when you ask it. Also, when it comes to general knowledge queries, Perplexity is just better because it's an LLM. Asking it things like how many days has it been since January 1st, Perplexity gives me the right answer. Now, I actually used to be able to ask my iPhone this question, and for some reason, it has no longer been able to do it. It will now fail over to ChatGPT, and ChatGPT knows, but for some reason, the built-in assistant can't do it. Also, questions like who is the vice president when Theodore Roosevelt was president, Perplexity gets it right the first time. I asked the voice assistant on iPhone several times, and it just can't get it. It can also do things that the built-in voice assistant can't do at all. Play that video from Stephen Robles' YouTube channel about iPhone security. I mean, that's pretty sweet. And it's automatically playing right here in the chat, or I can tap there to actually open it in YouTube. Play that new video from Stephen Robles' YouTube channel about iPhone security. Yeah, not exactly what I was looking for. So to break it down, Perplexity is better at composing emails for you with natural language, doing things like playing YouTube videos, and I think doing better at parsing your Apple Music requests, especially if you're not exactly sure the song or the artist. When it comes to playing podcasts, asking for directions, the built-in assistant's pretty good at that, and it can get some music requests. But the built-in assistant can't hail rides at all, and it can't make reservations, it just sends you over to the Maps app. Now, Perplexity is able to do this with the voice assistant because there are hooks into these things like reminders and calendar events already built into iPhone. Calendars or reminders can be accessed by third-party apps like Fantastical or Things. Same with contacts and things like your Apple Music, reminders, and more. But it can access things like your home data. So if you try to ask it to control your smart home,
it seems I don't have access to your smart home devices.
Yeah, so it can't access smart home devices. It also can't send text messages for you. But when it comes to just understanding your request, Perplexity does a much better job than the built-in assistant. Not to mention it can do all the things a modern LLM AI chatbot can do. You can ask it general knowledge questions, but I've mapped Perplexity voice assistant to my action button to use it more for on-device requests. And I'm gonna put a link to this shortcut in the show notes. This is now what I use for my action button. I used to just use my action button to skip forward 3 minutes whenever audio was playing, like podcasts that have a lot of ads, but I've done some customizations. Now you're gonna need the Toolbox Pro third-party app if you wanna use this shortcut. I'll put links to that and the shortcut in the video description. But what this shortcut does is it looks if audio is playing. That's a Toolbox Pro action. If audio is playing, it's going to seek forward by 3 minutes. I listen to podcasts that have really long ad breaks, and so seeking forward by 3 minutes is useful. And Apple Podcasts, you can only set 60 seconds max, so I like that. But if audio is not playing, so any other time I'm not listening to a podcast, it's going to start voice mode in Perplexity. I'll show you that in a second. But I also have this do something else. It gets my current location and gets my currently connected audio output device. That's another Toolbox Pro action. And then there's an if statement. So if the audio output device is my car and my general location is on my street, like Main Street, then it's going to open and close my garage. So now I can use my action button as a garage door opener, but it's only going to do that if I'm connected to my car Bluetooth and I'm home, or at least on my street. So this way I can get Perplexity voice search most of the time. If I'm playing a podcast, it'll skip forward and it'll toggle my garage up and down, which in iOS 18, you can toggle a HomeKit accessory rather than having to do a weird if statement. And that works for garage doors too. So because I'm not connected to my car and there's no audio playing to skip forward, it's gonna open the Perplexity voice assistant, start a chat, maybe play that song from the Sandlot movie. It was popular, I don't remember the name of it. Again, pretty sweet to recognize that. Let's see if the iPhone assistant can do that. Play that popular song from the Sandlot, I don't remember the name. Yeah, I don't think it got what I was saying. So while it's limited and not perfect, Perplexity has shown that having a legitimate large language model parsing requests for a voice assistant can be very useful on your phone, if just for playing music, but also composing emails, messages, finding restaurants, locations you want, and even hailing a ride. Some of the stuff that Apple promised from Apple Intelligence almost a year ago. which WWDC is coming very soon. It's actually on June 9th. I'm curious what Apple is going to announce when it comes to Apple Intelligence and the voice assistant. So get subscribed to the channel and hit that like button because I'm going to be covering it right here. By the way, if you want to see that video about keeping your iPhone secure and 10 settings that you should really look at right now, check out this video right here. If you haven't yet, I'd appreciate it if you subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. If you have any questions about Perplexity's voice assistant or anything else, leave those down in the comments, and I'll put another video right up here that YouTube thinks you'll really love. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.